These are Tasmanian devils. Of course, we are in a zoo, but we were very close to them. They're right behind this wall I'm standing behind. They are cute guys. A little bigger than a cat, a little chunkier than a cat, like a small dog. They aren't making any noise right now. There's the wall, they're behind. These are very rare, of course, Tasmanian devils. They are carnivorous marsupials. They're endangered species. There, you can see their faces now. Got a glimpse of his teeth.
Hey babe, look at the markings on the front. There's white spots.
Scars on his face.
Nearly an hour or so ago when we were feeding the ones just down yonder, I'll introduce myself again. I'm John. We'll off and do some preparation for our next activity, which is our little Birds of the Bush show, which is over here in about 10 or 15 minutes or so. The world of the Tasmanian devil is a world of darkness, and they're rarely seen. The idea that the Tasmanian devil is a bit like Taz in the cartoon is pretty false, you know. Hollywood's allowed to get away with things. You might think that, gee, that Taz cartoon, which made the Tasmanian devil sort of infamous rather than famous, I think, there were so many episodes. There were only five, actually. Coo, look at this. Cute, cute, cute. At our Unzoo, we'd like you to come and have a look at everything. Not a cuddly little creature. By the way, you can't cuddle these because they will bite. I'll go into some detail about the problem that's confronting devils. So the basic facts are they're marsupials that eat carrion, dead wallabies and possums. And they crunch up all the bones and they're found only here. But they're suffering from a cancer known as devil facial tumour disease. Or to be more correct, it's a neuroendocrinal carcinoma of subcutaneous origin. Has anybody anything to do with medicine or nursing? There we are. And now, you might have got a little bit of that.
These are eastern quolls, a very small carnivorous marsupial related to the Tasmanian devil. There are quolls on the Australian mainland too, but they're very unlikely to see them because they're nocturnal. This little guy is only about 7 inches long. He might be a baby. He let me touch his fur, although he was kind of nervous about it. Here's another view of the little eastern quoll. the brown one. He wants to sleep because he's nocturnal and it's morning. He's sleepy. These are foresters' kangaroos, the only type of kangaroo that's native to Tasmania. That's a male. He's waiting to be fed by the keeper, zookeeper, and there's some other coming.
If you just keep coming this way, guys, we'll feed him out the back a little bit, otherwise you'll walk in onto a field.
This is the kangaroos at feeding time. They're said to be very friendly. You can pat them on the back, but they don't like to be petted on the head. David's feeding them. David's a Dr. Doolittle. That's a patamelon. The patamelon wants the food. And the geese want it too. These are an Australian type of owl called the tawny frogmouth. Since they're owls, you would never see them in the wild. As David said, they're ugly birdies. They're pretty funny looking. And down the way, here's another one. Can't even get a good view of it. These two are just sitting there. They're a very strange bird. They seem to always be looking up. Okay, this one's opened its eyes and is looking at me. You can see it has strong beak. It's a type of owl.
Yeah.
This is a show with the tawny frogmouth.
I got a new one.
Looks like a kilo chicken when I buy one.